Hi, my name's Sam Pansino, and we're here at Bad Audio Concepts for NsayneTV, the show about modified cars and custom car audio systems. We're going to do a bit of a workshop tour. We've got Insane gear to show you as well. And we've also got the new season of Brett Files. I know you've all been hanging out for it. But this season in the Brett Files, we're going to cover car audio from start to finish. Basically, what it's all about, from head units right through to speakers, subs, amps, speaker wiring, power cable, the whole lot, why you do it, how you do it, how much would it approximately cost, and just basically help guide you as to what you should do, why you should do it, and how you should do it. So, hope you enjoy it all. There's going to be a bit where we're going to go over certain things a few times just to make sure everyone gets it. And if there's anything that you think we might have missed, you know, please feel free to drop us a line on info@insane.tv or jump onto our website, insane.tv, www first, and check it out. Let's jump in to the Brett Files! The Brett Files! The Brett Files! It's not as cold as it used to be. That's cool. Brett File time. I thought I'd just jump right in.
Jump right in.
What are we doing here?
This is the Brett Files. I'm Brett Morris, and this is Fat Audio Concepts. And the Brett Files is basically just trying to get a bit more technical information on car audio systems and in-car electronics.
And in case you're wondering, this is Stupid Sam. Stupid Sam isn't necessarily stupid, he's just wanting to learn. When the thinking cap's on, it's actually the learning cap. So tell me, what is car audio about? I've been to some of these Mobile Electronic Australia car audio competitions, seen some amazing systems. Some of these cars just sound absolutely mind-blowing. Why should I change the car audio in my car? I mean, I know a factory system sounds like ass, but what can you do to improve it?
Well, I mean, there's obviously a few different things depending on the car. You know, you could change your source unit, your head unit, to a higher quality unit, upgrading speakers, that sort of thing, just to improve the tonal balance in your car. If that's what the sound you're after, if you just want something that plays ridiculously loud, like a Chapel Street Cruiser or that sort of thing, obviously, you know, putting a big pair of subs in there, big amplifiers, that sort of thing, going for more of an SPL style car, or a sound quality car by replacing speakers and a small subwoofer just to give that bottom end.
Now, for those who don't know, SPL, you mentioned an SPL car. What's an SPL car?
SPL means sound pressure level. It's basically the volume or the technically the amount of air that's moved in the car and the amount of pressure inside the car, and that's measured in decibels. And just to give you an idea, the threshold of pain is 120 dB, I say, and a jumbo jet taking off is 130 dB. So, you know, you've got some cars putting out in excess of 150, 160. I think the world record's up to around 185 dB at the moment. That's pretty impressive.
That's insane.
Yes.
TV.
Insane TV. You can't sit in the... you can't sit in the car at those levels. You go deaf pretty much instantly, blow out eardrums, that sort of thing. Not a good thing, especially while you're driving.
Well, we'll hopefully cover SPL later on down during the Brett Files to see what it's all about, but mainly we'll stick with SQ for now because I know I want something with sound quality. Do I need to have a certain budget or can I just go in there? I mean, what are the different variations? What's your absolute minimum to absolute maximum?
Well, look, you know, again, as long as the car allows it, you know, as a minimum you can replace a head unit. That'll give you the best value for money upgrade in a car. Unfortunately, not all cars, you know, will accept changing the head unit. Some have integrated radios in the dashboard that you can't really change. The Audi the Audi TT is a perfect example of that. It's got a fully integrated head unit that has all the phone kit and steering wheel controls and everything built into it that you can't really go changing. So when you've got a system like that, the best way of doing is upgrading the audio side of it is things like audio processors, upgraded speakers and upgraded amplifiers.
I like it. So basically, keeping the factory, if I buy a brand new car and I want to keep the factory system because of the steering wheel controls, the nav, the whole functionality of the factory system, but I can still upgrade my speakers and amps and stubs, while maintaining my full factory head unit and get a great sound?
Definitely. Look, if you want to do a simple upgrade, you can just do a speaker replacement and an amplifier that will accept line level ins, which is the speaker level outputs from the factory radio. And that way you don't have to go with a processor or anything like that. But if you want the next step, if you want time correction, which we've covered before, which will allow you to put delays on speakers so all the sound gets to your head at the same time. Yeah, time correction, adjustable crossover points, EQ, parametric EQs, graphic EQs, that sort of thing. Then yeah, you do need to go an external processor. A couple of companies make some really good ones. Alpine do a good integration processor called the PXAH650. Really good little machine. It's what they call their imprint unit. Imprint's a technology we'll get into later on in the Brett files. Another good product is the Audison Bit 1. That's a great little machine. We'll take all your factory signal in and sum it all together and give a really good clean power output. Does auto EQing, all that sort of thing as well. So, for the ultra high end stuff, that's you definitely the unit to go for.
So what I should really determine is how much money am I sort of willing to spend, knowing that, okay, budgets are never, the budget should just be a guideline, not a strict rule.
Yeah, look, I mean, obviously, you have to go into anything with a budget. If you're building a house, you've got to have a budget, and a lot of people, a car is the second biggest investment they're ever going to make, so you really do have to go into it with a budget in mind. A lot of times that budget might get blown out of proportion, but it's always good to start off with a budget and work to that, and also, when you've got that budget, be realistic about it. If you've got the skills to do the installation yourself, well, that's great. But if you don't, you generally have to allow 60-ish percent of the value of the product towards installation for a quality installation. So, yeah, have to be realistic about it.
Because install can make a difference to the actual sound of the system as well. Like, you can have the best gear in the world, and if it ain't installed correctly, it's going to sound like crap.
Yeah, definitely. Installation's a major part of it, so has to be done perfectly.
So as long as you do your research, find out how much you want to spend, find out what you want to do with your car, whether you want to keep the original unit or change it, you can go everything from a amplifier with the line level in right up to an audio processor that gives you full tunability.
Yeah.
Okay, so now I've just got to determine how far I'm willing to go.
Yeah.
So what if I come at you next week with a couple of different price points, saying I've got $200 to spend, I've got $1,000 to spend, I've got $2,000 to spend, I've got $10,000 to spend. Well, just, if you can throw a couple of different choices, and then from there, we'll be able to make a selection. So
sounds good.
Brett, as always, thank you very much.
How we do it around here.
Ciao.
Ciao. All right.
Laters.
Brett Falls. See you next week.
That was Brett Morris.
That's Stupid Sam.
Laters.
See ya.
That was the Brett Files. Hope you found it informative. I always do. You always learn something from that guy. He's a bit of a... Anyways, now it's time for Insane Gear.
Hi, on Insane Gear this week, we're looking at the Audison Bit 1 signal processor. This is it here. This little box here is packed full of power. Basically, what this will do is let you interface through your factory head unit or an aftermarket head unit, give you lots of outputs for amplifiers. You can run a system fully active where each speaker gets its own channel. You can run it passive where it runs through crossovers, as we've discussed before. And it also gives you full control of time correction, crossover points, and equalization per channel. It's perfect if you're doing a system in a car that has a factory integrated head unit that you can't just replace because it's molded into the dashboard or incorporates the heater controls. So you need to get some kind of processing into the car. This unit will do that. It's all controlled via this little controller here. Audison called the DRC, or digital remote control. This sits at the front of the car. That becomes your volume control. You can also go through and select your sources via pushing the volume control in. You can also select your bass, treble, balance and fader, subwoofer levels, everything that you'd get on a normal head unit. And you can also have four selectable presets, A, B, C, and D. You can have them set for, say, set up for the driver's seat, one set up for the passenger seat, maybe one for both seats, and then one for just SPL, or just pure all-out loud volume, which will basically, you can turn off the front speakers, have it all coming through the subs, so you're not going to blow your front speakers. Infinitely adjustable. What that'll let you do is program the unit to suit your needs
time correction, crossover points, equalisation. We've got a car over here that we've got one fitted to, so maybe in insane hands we'll go check that out. Well, that was Insane Gear. Hope you enjoyed it. The Audison Bit 1 processor, beautiful bit of gear. It'll sound great in your car. Right, we'll see you again next week.
That was Insane Gear. Now it's time for the workshop tour. Let's see what we've got cooking in the garage today. Meet the Holden VTX YZE Avalanche. Got that in one shot, pretty cool. We've taken it a bit further since the last episode. You can see the front wheel arches, we've chopped them right out now. When this thing's dumped, you can still almost get full lock to full lock, which is pretty cool, although we won't be driving it with the bags dumped, but because we're fitting those widened wheel arches off the Avalanche, we're able to open these guards up, smooth it off a bit so it's not too sharp, and we're going to plastic weld or cross bond the wheel arches to the actual guard, so it's going to look really cool. But on that, we're also going to be cross bonding the big massive molds that go down the side, as well as the rear wheel arches. We're thinking of shaving off the fuel cap and putting the fuel cap behind some custom rear tail lights. We've got the new bar iron on, we're just going to fit some Rios onto there as well and make that bumper bar sit on there nice and strong. Windscreens are out as well, so both front and back windscreens are out. We use Jeff from A to Z Windscreens. He's incredible at his job, I love what he does. Got the roof all grinded back as well, ready for its etch primer, if you will. And we also have our new roof scoops off the VZ Avalanche, or XTYZE. It's off a Avalanche. We'll just stick with that because that's probably the easiest way to put it. We've blocked off all the holes, so they've all been plastic sealed. We're now going to plastic bog those up, sand it all down, put that into its first coat of primer as well. But these aren't going to get cross bonded. They're going to stay as a removable panel. They normally have big chunky roof racks sitting inside them, but we're not going to be running the roof racks, so we've seared them all off and they're going to look all nice in one piece, so it's going to look sexual. So loving this car at the moment. 22s, man. 22s on a Commodore. That's pretty insane. This is one insane ride. The Mustang. Have a look at her. Is she not beautiful? We've got a nice big high-rise manifold, big double pumper carby. We've got our NOS solenoids. This thing's just got the works. Electronic ignition. What else do we have in this? Got a big Gilmer belt set up. Couple of fuel pump regulators. Some big rocker covers, because that means he's got some screw and stud roller rockers happening under there as well. So he'll be running a solid cam or even a roller cam, depending on how big we go. There's a washer model that's got FOMOCO written on it. Just for those people that wanted to know, FOMOCO is a Ford Motor Company in Mexico. So if you've got any FOMOCO parts on your Ford, they were more than likely built by the Mexicans. Go the Mexicans! Evato! Windscreens are out. As I said, the bodywork on this was pretty damn neat to start with, but wanted a bit of a freshen up, so we're just giving it a quick blow over. We'll show you this thing once it's painted. It's had the touch of God, aka V2. And yeah, obviously in DNA paint, because if you love your car, you'd only paint it with DNA, because they make some of the craziest paints, man. And yeah, this thing's just going to be black with a hint of something. We're not sure what we're hinting towards yet. So hopefully Brian will come in and hint us into the correct direction. So Brian, help us on this one, please. He's the best paint guru you'll ever come across. And yeah, the man's very artistic with his colors. And with cars like this, he can look at a car, see its shape, and he'll say, you know what color would suit that? I'd try this. And Vito would try a sample and say, Brian, you're a legend. That you are. If we look at the carby, the height of that carby sitting on top of that high-rise manifold, that's the reason why that bonnet scoop had to go back on. It hangs out of the bonnet. The reason why you go for high-rise manifolds is because you want high RPM power, not low RPM power. So this thing, power would normally kick in about 4,000 RPM onwards. So if you're going for a lower revving RPM engine, so if you want something that kicks in at about 2.5 to 3 grand, you'd fit a dual plane manifold or a low manifold. You wouldn't go so high. The higher you go, you get that tunnel ramming effect, which is only really good for high RPM, flat out just type of power, which that's what these babies are all about. It's a Ford. I love Fords. Check out this baby and look at those fluffy dice, man. Years ago, fluffy dices were a bit on a car like this, it belongs, man. It's so cool. So, Steph, love your car, bruh. Not your car, bruh. Your car, bro. Bruh. No, I'm just going to step out of picture so you can enjoy. Yoink! Maserati. The badges are on. Car's finished. All we got to do is put the windscreens in. And yeah, we're really happy how fast this one came along. Die, he tricked me. They're just on there temporarily. Good on you, Vito. Now, as you can see, rest of the car's all in its final stage of high fill. Boot lid's still in its first one, but we had to fit the extension lip on the back of the spoiler, try out the Maserati badge, and I thought my phone would ring. Listen to how fast my phone can go. Wait for it. Now. That was at least a 4 second phone. That's cool. But I better answer this because it's Willie's world. Willie! This is a live recording. We are actually talking to you live in front of the camera. That was Willie. he's looking forward to finally hooking up his car. So in the meantime, back to the Maserati, aka Project A. You can see down the side, the whole thing's all nice. I won't say glossy white, it's a matte white high fill. There's probably a reason for the white high fill. I'm not sure as yet. I'll have to ask Vito. I know there is, but I just wanted to confirm it. And inside's all, as we said last time, it's all been sandblasted, ready to high fill the inside as well, because we want the inside to look just as good as the outside. The bonnet lines are unbelievable. Like, this thing's just lined up incredible. Hopefully by next week, we'll have the front bar on. We'll get the front bar into the perfect lines as well. And then the front bar gets its second coat of high fill. Then we're probably only a couple of weeks away from painting this thing. So, and Vito said he's going to let us jig up in the spray booth so we can watch him paint it, guys. Woohoo! And girls, woohoo! And all those in between, woohoo! And any aliens out there watching, woohoo! Let's keep walking around. But you guys have a look. I'm going to keep walking around. Project X, Project Y, let's just call it Project XY, because it's an XY, how cool. It's all in its final rub back stage. This puppy is ready to go into the booth and paint. As you can see, Brian's selection of the silver metallic in this car is just insane. Once you see it on the rest of the body, wow. It's exceeding our expectations, but that's what everything does here as we're working them. They just go way over the top and it's unreal. So we're just, yeah, waiting to get another car out of the booth, and then this puppy's going in. So hopefully in the next episode or two, you'll see this thing all painted up. So we're going to ask him that when the car goes away and fits his engine, that he brings it back so we can do a feature on it, because it's getting one serious muscle engine. So we do some serious muscle cars here, Jap cars, Euro cars, the whole lot. We cover all bases, and they're all just as gorgeous as this. So not as gorgeous as me, but yeah, not bad. I'll get out of the picture again so you can enjoy. Yoink! The year was 1984, the month was July, and Modern Motor said, we drive the Exa Turbo Racer. That's the car that we're building, the one behind the other one. We'll open the book up, have a quick look, and we'll show you what it's going to look like when we're finished. Look at that puppy, that's a car. That's cool. Goes to show, no matter what ride you have, you can always make it look cool if you're willing to be different. This is just gonna look tough, man. It's gonna look insane. But we do warn you, Tim, you need to get some pretty damn big wheels to fill these wheel arches. Let's have a look at how wide this thing is. It's like twice as wide as the original tyre. It's so cool. Have a look. Tim, the kid's in. Damn. Look how wide this puppy is, man. That is huge. So the car's going to be painted in white. It's going to look like the original Bathurst car. Not sure if he's going to do all the stickers, but wow, this is fat, man. That's the way we like it. Insane. The only way to do it. As I said, regardless of the car that you have, if you're willing to be different, anything's achievable, and this is a prime example. This thing will turn heads no matter where it goes. And I gotta admit, pretty damn good fitting kit. The rear quarter panels, just as big, but they bolt on. They've got that big chunky eye bolt on sort of look, and these ones we're gonna seam on, rear ones we're gonna just bolt on and give it that real grunge sort of look. I couldn't walk away without showing you how wide this rear quarter panel is. That's a wide body. That is cool. You can see where the holes are for the bolts to go through. So we're going to put some rivet inserts that have got the threads inside them, like the nut inserters, into the body, and then just put some button head Allen key things into the side area of this wheel arch, and they'll look like they're really bolted on, and yeah, just give it that real aggressive grunty look. So yeah, can't wait to do this one. It's going to look tough, man. Cool. That's enough for this car. Let's move on. Right now, this reminds me of that Twilight show about that zone place. I feel kind of freaky. Hey, oh, how you doing? The Murano. What can you do to a Murano, you say? Pull out the little tub that sits in the quarter there, whack in a 10-inch sub, whack in an amplifier, hook it up to some speakers, change the head unit. This thing's going to be rocking without going over the top. Because the bass is in the same cabin space as the driver, we're going to get some pretty serious sound. But the way we integrate things around here, it looks like it was meant to be there. That's how we do it. The color carpet matched almost perfectly. The way it just flows throughout the whole quarter panel. And it takes up no room. I mean, if I can still fit in the back, and you can probably fit another three bodies in here. I mean, underbelly, eat your heart out. I better get out of here. I'm back at the back. Check it out, it's pretty cool. That was the workshop tour. Hope you like what you saw. Now it's time for the feature car. Let's have a look. First up, the stainless steel mesh. That thing's gorgeous. Really, really strong and tough. It has the same insert down the bottom, giving it a bit of a theme. We'll make our way around the side of the car, and let's have a look at the doors. Look at that. Cobalt candy fiberglass door trims. The actual speaker grille itself is designed off the door handle, so you've got the two chrome, or the two silver strips running through. And we used body color around the actual speaker pods themselves just to make a highlight of it, which wherever there's a speaker in the car, it's surrounded by body color, so there's a bit of a theme. So wherever we've got a speaker, there's a bit of body color, then there's a bit of cobalt candy, all supplied by DNA paints. Surprising that. We'll get inside the car, we'll have a look at the iPod holder, we'll have a look at the new head unit that's in there as well, the new state-of-the-art head unit. It's absolutely amazing. Do you reckon we can all squeeze in? Let's have a try. What we're looking at here is the main Alpine front tweeter. The tweeter on top of the dash is actually an ambient tweeter, which plays from 16 kilohertz to 20 kilohertz, only playing the highest of the highs to help give the car a lot of stage height. Check her out, the new IXAW404 iPod control, gives you a little screen there. And if we hit the source button, look at that, that's just cool. I'm just going to play around with this for a while. Don't mind me. Hey, actually, let's go down this way. We got radio, no one radio. DVD changer, no, I don't want DVD changer. iPod, nah. Nah, we'll go back to iPod. Video, movies. What have we got? Cars, always a good movie. And before you know it, how cool is that? Following the same theme as the doors, we've got the cobalt candy, we've got body color surrounding the speakers, we've got two 10-inch monitors. These used to be the drop-down monitors, but we've cross-bonded the monitors into a bit of fiberglass and MDF, and then put the speakers in there as well, mounted from behind, so it's a screwless installation. You can't see any screws through the whole install. Then if we get into the bottom of the boot, looking on the side panels, made exactly like the door trims. We've got the dark grey up top with the first silver stripe running through it, then the light grey, then the cobalt candy, and then the silver stripe down the bottom. So that whole theme runs through the whole car. The shape of the actual boot panels themselves are the same shape as the doors, so it literally follows the quarter panel as if they were meant to be in there from Chrysler themselves. How unusual for us. You can see the four subs running in there. We're using the stainless steel rods with washer jet hose wrapped over the top so that way they don't arc out. Once again, mounted to a candy cobalt blue floor with the body color trim rings surrounding them. And then if we take a look at all those amplifiers, they're mounted on a spiral case that's bolted to the top of the parcel shelf. So the amps are actually hanging. They're not mounted on the floor. They actually hover just above the floor. So you can probably see my hand moving around in there. We've got 3mm Perspex lit up from inside with a few LEDs, so it helps every amplifier glow. That was the Alpine 300C, the feature car for this episode. Hope you enjoyed it. See it soon at a show near you. Diddle-doo, 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 diddle-doo. That was the feature car. Hope you enjoyed it. We've got more of the feature car next week, so please stay tuned. That was this episode. I hope you enjoyed all of it. Go to www.insane.tv. Check out our website, see what we've got going on. Keep an eye out for some cruises, because we've got some crazy cruises coming up with summer coming on. Can't wait. It's going to be killer. See you next week. I'd like to remind you about joining our Facebook group. Just search for Fad Audio Concepts, join, and chat with other car enthusiasts. Leave questions and comments and feedback for either myself or Brett, and we'll do the best to incorporate your feedback into the show.
Hi, on this week's episode of Insane Gear, we'll be looking at this. Funny's beautiful spatula. It's a quality... Hi, on this week's episode of Insane Gear, we'll be looking at this little sucker. The Audison Bit 1 Sitter...
My name's Sam Pansino, we're here at Fad Audio Concepts, and I've done that totally wrong. Let's start again.
Hi, on this week's episode of Insane Gear, we'll be looking at this. A beautiful... I'll start again. I'll get this off. Seriously. Hi, on this week's episode...
Hi, my name...
Hi, my name's Sam Pansino, and welcome to... come on, break the... It's happening
again. I don't know. I don't know what else to say.